Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're gonna be talking about performance upgrades and modifications for Ford's 5.4 liter V8 Triton engine. The 5.4 Triton was produced in a number of different variants. There was a 2-valve and a 3-valve single overhead cam engine, and then there was a 4-valve dual overhead cam engine. Now, despite all the different variants, the performance modifications are going to be the same for all of these engines. The main difference is just going to be the starting horsepower that you're working with, and as well as how the engines respond to these modifications from a power gain standpoint. The 5.4 Triton produced anywhere from 235 horsepower in its weakest applications all the way up to 550 horsepower in the supercharged 4-valve dual overhead cam engine. In this video, we're going to talk mostly about basic bolt-on modifications. And to explain why, let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the power limits of the 5.4 Triton. Now, the 5.4 Triton uses a cast iron block, and the block is extremely strong and durable. It can handle upwards of 800 plus horsepower. However, you start to get limited on the internals. There is the 550 horsepower supercharged version of these engines that use stronger internals, but if you don't have a supercharged from the factory engine, you're going to be stuck with cast iron pistons and connecting rods, which are only able to handle about 400 to 450 horsepower. So when we start looking at modifications for this engine, to get to that 400 plus horsepower level is when we're going to need to start looking into things like camshaft upgrades and supercharger kits. And of course, from there, that gets into a ton of other modifications that need to get done, and so ultimately it gets expensive. Furthermore, the fuel system has some limitations. The stock injectors are only good for the low 300s horsepower range, and then the stock fuel pump can only handle about 350 horsepower. So to get past 400 horsepower, not only are we talking about forced induction or supercharger kits, we're also talking about a number of fueling related upgrades on top of all of these other basic modifications that will need to be done. So we're going to save all of those more advanced modifications for a different time, because for the most part, unless you have a really big budget, doing these basic bolt-on modifications is going to give you a pretty respectable amount of power. And if you want to go further than that, that's when you're going to need to start looking into a lot more of these advanced upgrades, especially if you want to push past 450 horsepower, at which point you're going to need to start looking at breaking into the motor and upgrading the internals. Camshafts are a good modification, but my recommendation is to start with this list of bolt-on modifications first, see how you're looking from a power standpoint, if that's giving you everything that you want, and then go from there. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into our list of modifications. The first thing that we have is tuning. Tuning is where your big power gains are going to come from. It's going to offer the biggest kind of bang for the buck from a price to horsepower standpoint on these engines. And it's one of the most important things, because some of these engines are a little bit temperamental. So getting proper custom tuning done on them is one of the best things that you can do from both a performance standpoint, but also for a reliability standpoint once we start talking about adding more power to these engines. So from a tuning standpoint, I recommend doing a little bit more than just buying a basic tuner and plugging it in. You'll want to go ahead and buy something from a reputable tuner like 5-Star, who offers their tuners preloaded with custom tunes on them. And that will help you maximize power gains, but also reliability, since they're a little bit better than just the basic off-the-shelf maps that you get on something like an SCT X4, for example. But overall, these engines respond pretty well to tuning. And so just with a basic tuner and some decent tuning, you can get around 25 to 50 horsepower gains. Moving on to the second upgrade, we have an intake system. Intakes alone aren't really going to provide a ton of power to these engines. The factory intake is actually decent. However, the factory air filter is what's restrictive. You've got two options from an intake standpoint. You can either drop a high flow KNN filter in there, or you can go ahead and upgrade the whole thing. There is a little bit of additional benefit to upgrading the whole intake piping, because the factory intake system does have a pretty nasty 90 degree bend in it. And so you can get an upgraded intake that has a little bit more smooth of piping, which just allows for better airflow. But like I said, you're not gonna see massive power gains out of an intake, but you will help free up a little bit of power and help bring more air to the engine, which is an important thing once we start talking about tuning and exhaust upgrades and other things that add power to these engines. Another thing that you can do from here is get a larger throttle body. I will say the benefit of a larger throttle body is not really huge, and so it's not something that I would recommend spending the money on up front. But if you get to a point where you really want to maximize airflow, then that is another thing that can be done on these engines to help just improve airflow to the engine. The third modification on the list, I'm going to go ahead and group into the whole exhaust system. But the most important parts of the exhaust system are really going to be the headers. The headers are where you're going to get big power gains. Just from upgrading the headers with proper tuning, you can get about 25 horsepower gains out of it. And then, of course, if you want to take things a little bit further just to free up exhaust flow even more, you can upgrade the X-pipe as well as the cat-back portion of the exhaust system. Now, a full exhaust upgrade isn't really needed. I would say do the headers for sure. And then if you want to go a little bit further, go ahead and do the X-pipe. But if you don't want your car to be extremely loud, you can keep the factory cat-back on there because the biggest power gains are going to come from those first two components. Overall, with a full exhaust system, you can see 30 to 35 horsepower gains when combined with proper tuning. So just from headers and tuning alone, and an intake on there, or a high flow drop in, we can get about 50 to 80 horsepower gains out of the 5.4 Triton. And then, like I mentioned, a couple other things that you can consider are throttle body upgrades if you really want to maximize airflow. And then the second thing to potentially consider is camshaft upgrades. But there are a lot of considerations from a power band standpoint and from a drivability standpoint when it comes to camshafts. And so I'd recommend doing these things first, and then from there, go ahead and try to make the decision of whether you want to add a camshaft or not. I would say a camshaft would be the next thing to do unless you want to go ahead and start looking at forced induction. If you want to look at forced induction, then a camshaft is something to take into consideration while you're looking at forced induction. But to maximize these engines and keep them naturally aspirated, you'll want to go ahead and do a camshaft unless you want to start getting into crazy options like porting the heads and things like that. And so from another kind of not as much bolt-on standpoint, but more entry-level modification, you know, something like a stage one camshaft can add some pretty good power gains if you're looking just for a little bit extra. But all in all, pushing past the 400 horsepower mark is when stuff starts to get a little bit more complex and complicated, just because we have to start looking into the fueling system and we're going to need to add forced induction. And once we add forced induction, you have a very small amount of room until you're getting to a point that the internals are going to need to be upgraded. So ultimately, these 5.4 Tritons are good engines to throw some basic bolt-on modifications on, but they aren't great engines to do some really serious high horsepower builds unless you have a deep budget to be able to really break into the engine and bulletproof it and upgrade all of the internal components that need to be upgraded. With that being said, guys, tuning, an intake or a drop-in filter, and an exhaust system, and you can add a pretty good 50 to 80 horsepower to these engines. And ultimately, you can do these for a relatively cost-effective price. That would be my recommendation of where to start on these engines, but if you guys are looking for more, go ahead and stay tuned to our channel as we'll do more videos on the 5.4 Triton later. That's all we've got for this one, so if you guys appreciate the content, please click the like button and subscribe to stay tuned to all the future content we have coming.